So as you can see here, you can focus. So as you can see here, it is called as French diffusion cell, and it is a kind of, you know, vertical type, because you have receiver compartment and this is called as donor compartment, okay? In the receiver compartment, there is, you know, inner receiver, okay, receiver cell. It comes with the different sizes. So you have to measure the size or the volume of the receiver compartment, which is going to be taken into the consideration, into calculation. So first of all, before starting experiment, you have to measure, you have to fill it, okay, and see how much volume is coming here. Okay, this is first thing. And other thing you will see here, the inlet and outlet, this is for water jacket. You can put hot water from here, okay, from one side, and you know, it is circulating to make it like, you know, heating at 32 or 37 degree centigrade, okay? So outer jacket is for heating only, okay? And this port is for introduction of the media, diffusion media, and also for sampling. You can take after, you know, after putting the media here, okay? You can take from here at half hour, or it could be faster, mine 10 minutes, 15 minutes, okay? So take the media from here and also replace it, fresh media, okay? So this is receiver compartment, and here you put the membrane, okay? Like example, we have here the membrane, but you have to cut in this size, okay? You have to cut in this size and put here, and then you have to put here, okay? So what is important here, this is called as donor compartment, and this is opening is, you know, donor opening, and from here, you know, if you put the membrane here, and so it will, if, and put it, your drug here, so drug will cross the membrane, okay? So you have to take the surface area of the membrane, okay? So you it means that you have to measure the surface area and the diameter of this opening also. You can see here, it is around 1 centimeter, okay? So 10 millimeter, the diameter of this opening is 10 millimeter, so you will calculate the area, okay, by, you know, taking this diameter, 2 pi r, okay, or pi r square, 2 pi r is very, so you will calculate, you know, area of this, you know, this circle, so that it will be area of the skin, okay? So you will cut the same size, okay, like you can cut in the same size and put here, and then you can tighten this, okay, by using this membrane, okay? You have to tighten this, for example, like this one. Okay. Like, okay, this is tightened now. And after this, you have to put your drug here. Drug should be weight or quantified half gram, or usually it should cover the this membrane, okay? So you can put here half gram or maybe 0.25 gram, whatever. If it is liquid, you simply put here by the pipette, half ml, okay? If it is semi-solid like ointment cream, so you have to put here, you can, you know, drop here, if, for example, this one, okay? What we will do, what we are going to do in this case is that first take the weight of this whole assembly, okay, put here the liquid also, measure the liquid, put the whole assembly, and then take the weight of this, okay, in the balance, and then from here, you know, put some amount here and measure the again the weight. So it will be the total weight, you can put maybe 0.25 gram or half gram, okay? So after taking the weight of this one, put some amount here and measure the weight. This will be the weight of the drug you put here, okay? After you finish it, you have to just, you know, put it on the shaker. Ideally, you know, you put here, it is very small, so it is difficult. Ideally, there is, you know, very small magnetic stirrer. You put in there inside the receiver cell and put it, the whole assembly, on the magnetic stirrer. it will revolve. Okay, we don't have this assembly, it is not possible to be very small. What we can do, we'll put this in the shaking path. Okay?
Okay,
put here and it will revolve slowly. Stop the machine and take the sample, then start again for shaking. Just, you know, usually this experiment is done for, you know, 4 to 8 hours usually, but sometime it is, you know, can be extended up to 24 hours or even 48 hours. Okay, we have less time, so we can do the frequent sampling. Okay, so what you get actually after sampling at 10 minutes, 20 minutes, half hour, you will take concentration. We will find out the amount crossing the membrane. Okay, and then you will make a plot, amount of the drug which cross at every time point. Okay, so time point versus the amount of the drug which cross the membrane is plotted. It will give you the flux. Okay, flux is the total amount of the drug per centimeter square of the skin per minute or per hour. This is called as flux of the drug. And then from here you can calculate the permeability of the membrane. Okay, several parameters you will see in the table, it is available. Okay, so this is all about the experiment. So first thing, you measure the volume and the diameter. Okay, fill the, you know, media here and put the membrane and take the weight of this whole assembly, then put the drug, take the weight of the drug, how much you put here, and take sampling. After 10 minutes, start the sampling. Clear?
Okay.